Isoweto has a lot of opportunities in terms of public. And also a PR. You understand? So it doesn't need a PR or a marketing to get somewhere. He was stressed, even cut his ear. And no, my paintings work. They are worth millions. 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 You understand? I grew up as a very, very quiet guy. Mm-hmm. Very shy.
Yeah.
The only time I could express how I felt inside was through a paper and a pencil.
Mm.
Yeah. So, I was I was alone most of the time.
Mm.
I had friends, but I preferred peace. I've preferred my own space. I'm a dreamer.
Okay.
Like, I live in my own world. A lot of guys about Pumeka, so Soweto.
Okay.
You understand?
Yeah.
There's a lot of animators about Pumeka, so Soweto.
Yeah.
You understand? It's just that now, with those people, are they investing back la bapuma khona? You understand? Because there's no point ukuthi uqove talent lakho lisengara lihlale ngara
ningabuye
ingamla zizospanisa. You understand? Zizospanisa and say no, we can do our own, we can use your talent.
Yes.
But exploit it.
Yo, don't forget to get a little poster, right? It's the like of things as the SAM Chronicles family will be bringing you content from Ekasi.
But yeah, man. On top of the building, on top of the things, on top of the ASM, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. It's yet another beautiful and exciting episode of the ASM Chronicles. This is the KTS, where each and every important conversation happens. You need to join us. If you want to be alerted and be notified, please do not forget to subscribe on our YouTube channel. It's the ASM Chronicles, not the SMS. Let me spell it out to you guys. It's ASM Chronicles on YouTube. Type there to subscribe. Press the notification button so that whenever we drop, you are going to be notified. Yeah. On top of the things, my name is Mokete Maiman, aka Max Maximum Temperature. And I am not alone. Of course, I have the one and only Mchita Wame, my co-host. Introduce yourself.
You know, it's your boy Atam Pashele. I'm one third of the ASM Chronicles. What's it? Get it, it's your first time, Buffet. Don't forget to like, subscribe to the ASM Chronicles. Let me take it back to the host.
Indeed, that's how we do it, bro. Guys, you know, we bring you, of course, you know, exciting guests, people who have a story to share. And obviously, that story is for you to listen to grasp and learn. If you do learn, please leave down a comment. And if you want to ask any questions to our guest, you can, you know, drop down your questions. We will give it to him and then they will answer to you. So today joining us, he's a painter. You know, he is an entrepreneur. You know, he's an animator. You know, things that you guys are not familiar with.
Yeah.
So it is time. And please do make sure that you learn from this conversation. Stay in this conversation. I hope you're going to learn a lot. You know, when it comes to painting, and you know, like giving that visual aspect, giving the visual aspect of life. Today we have Oprah Elliot, you know, who is here with us, joining us all the way from
Ndofaya.
God is so new. Bra Elliot is here with us to share, you know, a story of who he is. If Haumtsebe, you know, he's going to give us a brief introduction of Ugutubani and then Wenza. Let me give it to you, Hotman Lami.
Okay, sure, chance.
Ula, Hotman.
First of all, you guys gave me this platform to able to talk and share my story around my talent.
Yeah.
So Ikama Elliot Sithole, I'm originally from the East Rand, Ekatlehong, K1. Resided this side 2019 because I was teaching. I had to teach this side. I was given an opportunity by Iskoles Bizwa Ipeu Entle. Esila Zone 10 Midlands. So they gave me an opportunity to come and teach. They had like students there who were doing fashion design and stuff. So I had an opportunity with Zobafundisa like a digital art on how to sketch comments and how to design comments on digital stuff. Because here I can see most of the time we are not introduced into digital stuff a lot. You know, Masbon is it digital, which is it is I North, so we must sense in. So since I've studied animation, I was like, let me just come here and do something, give to the community, share my knowledge to the community. So yeah, that's when I got that platform.
Interesting.
This is the first. This opportunities that we don't know.
You're
given an opportunity to head. When you say head, you left the job or what happened? Before
we so I was given a short time to teach. It was just like a year and a half. It was just something. I mean, it wasn't something that I thought that I wanna do one day. Yeah. But I've loved teaching. I've once taught kids art, fine arts.
Yeah.
So for me it was like, oh wow. This is a different one. I'm going to teach about laptop computers, how to draw with your computer, how to animate with your computer. So that was an opportunity for me. So Umam Diale gave me that opportunity. She's late now.
Okay.
Yeah, she gave me that opportunity to teach. And yeah, so it was a good experience. And I've learned a lot as well from the students and how people see things. And I've noticed that we need to implement more of such career paths, my animation, graphic design, you know, because we are very lacking on that, because you find like my parents, they will take abantwana babo esikolweni and to just implement one mentality, which is be a teacher, be a doctor, be a lawyer. Where else there's a lot of opportunities and you find out that child is very talented. And the talent is boxed. He or she can't express herself or himself. So that was a good opportunity for me, and I've learned, Guti, there are so many people who are talented.
This thing brings me to the question, Guti, because when you speak about digital creation, like, was it easy, you know, to finding that gap, especially here, Ekasi?
It wasn't easy. It wasn't easy at all. Noticing it was easy because you could see, Guti, like, when they asked me, I'll say, animation, and I'll have to explain. You understand?
Something that's far from
And with the knowledge of art as well, that's the first mentality and the thing that they think of. And which is, art is very broad. It's like art is business. It's not just a talent of you waking up drawing people or painting people and then that's it. It's a business.
When you say that, Hotman, for some of us now, used to draw, but not like an artist, but it was once where I've had like a school like being in a clip village.
Mm.
So there were competitions that were run by Bo Ram working Albani.
Yeah.
But it was for a certain time. And now for us to get inspired, Tina Pella, as the now generation, we need something that we need to believe, okay, it's guaranteed to make money because our parents force us to see Bama Doctor and anything. We need stories like yours to tell with okay. There's people who could do. I didn't think South Africans we can do anime.
Yeah.
By now I'm thinking, oh, Super Strikers. So I'm thinking now, okay, we need, before we do something, we need to hear a story first. Mm. Obana, you sharing your story today, it's gonna make us believe in ourselves, because the thing in the society is us. We need to believe in ourselves. We can say, okay, there's. I didn't know there was a school of like in the middle that I can take now. And now since I have my mind, I can tell my little brothers, okay, there's many opportunities.
Mm.
But do you think or these opportunities are there for everyone now? Because now from hearing from where Pumekatleho until a Sarala, it's a way to hot man. We don't know about that.
Mm. You know, I always say with Soweto is a very privileged place to be. East Rand is very dull, and East Rand has a lot of talent. There's lots and lots of talent, especially when it comes to creativity. East Rand has a lot of talent. It's just that the opportunities are not that much like
Soweto.
I understand.
You can agree, but we're in Soweto. Yeah. Where are the opportunities?
So you won't see, obviously, Maunga Parat.
Okay.
You understand?
Yeah.
But when, I mean, you know, I can have a brand, a cars. Let's say this brand of mine.
It's a
cars.
Yeah.
It's a Katle home.
Yeah.
And then, like Soweto, you guys won't know it.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
And then, but I can have a brand, a Soweto. A Katlehong, they will know it.
Yes.
You understand? So hence I'm saying, Guti, Soweto has a lot of opportunities in terms of public.
Oh,
and, and also a PR.
Yeah,
yes,
yeah,
so it's just Zenzela. You understand? So it doesn't need a PR or get marketing somewhere. To get somewhere. It just happens.
That's
it's
true.
Like USA, America.
Yeah.
America, they have nothing. They depend on Africans.
Exactly.
You understand? Yeah. But the fact with EPR, I've been doing music videos, music.
Yeah. We want to be them.
Movies, we want to be like them. The way they dress, whatever. Even so, way to everything starts here.
Mm.
You understand? So, so you ask yourself, Guti, okay, I'm a company, not my animators.
Yeah.
You find a lot of guys about Pumeka, so wait.
Okay.
You understand?
Yeah.
There's a lot of animators about Pume, so wait.
Yeah.
You understand? It's just that now, with those people, are they investing back to Laba Puma Corn?
Oh.
You understand?
Yeah.
Because there's no point to Ukovi talent Lakuli saying Ada, Lishalingada. Ingamla, this is Spanish. You understand? This is Spanish and say, no, we can do our own, we can use your talent.
Yes.
But exploit it.
And then
understand? And then you don't have the opportunity to say, let me go back and invest the cash, move the scale up, or teach Abantuana. You understand? So,
But in that context, I believe with you, sometimes I don't blame them for not coming back to us, because now we are given opportunities, but sometimes what manipulates us, such things, because people want more on apparel. We must look at certain things like that, you know?
Yeah. But then you can't crucify people who wanna learn.
Yeah.
Because I want you to learn no more.
Okay.
It's like saying unenda abogutu muntu tini.
Yeah.
You understand? Mm. So you can't crucify a 6-year-old or 8-year-old who's very talented, who doesn't know what you're doing, a talent job. Or you can't crucify someone who's matriculated and have papers and very skillful.
Mm.
You understand? Because I want to mama, that's why I said to you before, art is a business.
Okay.
It's not something that you draw, paint, and exhibit or wait for exhibitions.
Yeah.
You can create art. You can make t-shirts out of
art.
You can make caps. You can have a brand on that. You understand? It's not something that's statement. So you being there and saying, I want bangada by a kawatana, by a lawyer, and by enza. If it's this, it's not gonna change.
Yeah.
So you cannot crucify abantwana because when are you scared to bring that skill that you have learned evalungin and bring it here and share with the young ones. Yeah, well.
Okay. So the question I would ask now is, like, why are you so invested in bringing it back home now?
Fana, I. You know how I grew up, ne? It was just me and my uncle. And that guy taught me a lot of things in life, you know. First of all, the first teaching he would tell me is that don't forget home.
Okay.
You understand?
Yeah.
Home is home. Whatever you do, even if you pay 10 rand, ulambile, and then you wanna buy a quarter, a stratin.
Yeah.
You understand? Think good to nabo put, nabo see se kaya. You understand? Yeah. So you do not, you don't become greedy.
Yeah.
You understand? Abantu bagini, you need to always remember them.
Okay.
You understand? Mm. Because the reason why you see child trafficking, rape, housebreaking, it's because there's no investment in Lushin. Okay. You understand?
Yeah.
So people like us, I wish good to fit manka to win a lot or I get that opportunity. I take my money ilangada. Masses should be less so we a car. You understand? Well we a car if you didn't wanna invest, yeah, you get it.
It's a very good thing, Oyenza, because it's something that, you know, Nati, we need to learn from Amakhotmana Fana now, so that we understand the value of ukulisa skill to a point of which is cool, and then come back. Because you'll never know Guti who might, you know, take that skill as funde naya fane nawe and go abroad. Speaking of, you know, ukula and prioritizing, I mean, I just wanna ask Guti, you know, when you started doing what you are doing, what is it that you started prioritizing first? You know, between entrepreneurship, you know, painting and
to be honest, it was entrepreneurship because the skill was already there.
Okay.
Yeah, bro. So I needed to learn more about business. You know what's funny thing is with business, you never stop learning. You understand? You never stop learning how to handle money. You never stop learning how to grow your business. You understand? So business for me was the most important thing because there is no point of me painting and nibe stuck lapaya ne painting yami. I don't know how to price my painting. You understand? I don't know. I'm pricing painting yami 120 by 150 millimeters, centimeters by 500. And then you see I'm killing myself. It's because now I don't understand the business side of the thing. You understand? That I'm talented with, because ungulukula yakayito ukuthi uhlale nayo uzivalele endlini upende. You understand? Like, if you look, I don't know if you guys know who Vincent van Gogh. Vincent van Gogh was an artist, French artist, I think. That guy, he never sold one painting.
Why?
He was stressed, even cut his ear. And no, my paintings work. They're worth millions. Millions. Like, not like, not millions in Yana, like millions. You understand? So that's because he didn't understand the business side. And he didn't understand his talent. You understand? He couldn't sell.
So how would you educate people to quantify their art? Because we have talent, but we don't know the business side of it. Because now, as you can see now, there's many artists who grew up like you who do not know the business side. How can you quantify your businesses? Because sometimes, like, for example, Tina, when we charge for match, we charge looking at, okay, how do we get the match? How do we print? And certain things. Okay, that's how we can quantify. Okay, to charge a certain t-shirt or hoodie is because the process went like this. Nah, si charge because of silanda la 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 la. So how can someone who does painting quantify their art in terms of quality? Because you can quantify it with my art, I'm like an OG with what I'm doing. Mm. But how do I convince people or they should buy my art for that, man?
Look, I always say, you see, a talent and creativity,
yeah,
it's priceless. You can't put a price.
Damn.
You're putting a price because you need that money,
okay,
right now. But yeah, that talent, it's priceless.
Mm. Okay.
You understand? So there was this one friend of mine. She's like, yo, I got my t-shirt. I was like, yeah, I'm not selling a t-shirt. I'm selling art.
Damn.
You understand? Because if I'll say, you love my art.
Mm.
You love my art. But then you can't afford it.
Yes.
So the least I can do is have my art on the t-shirt.
Yeah.
So that you can afford it at least.
Yeah.
With that small malinyana or nah.
Yeah.
You understand? It can be 700.
Yeah.
I can't go down less than that. You understand? Already I've taken a piece that cost 20K.
Damn.
And I put it on my t-shirt.
Yeah.
And then I say 700.
We are complete.
Yo. So yeah, talking about taking your art to a t-shirt, your new business venture with Kanaging Shinobi, ne?
Yeah,
Shinobi. Yeah, how did it come about? Because now, what you speak about your business venture, now I can see what you're talking about.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Why specifically Shinobi to collaborate with your art?
Yeah, Olinda has been one of my role models.
Okay.
Like us, when I came here, I saw the brand Shinobi, and I was like, wanted to know more about it. And now the way the guy carries himself, you see, this guy is all about Monday to Monday work.
Okay.
Making money.
Yeah.
So I've always checked his work, and he's one guy, he's got Unes tools, you understand? In everything that he does.
Yeah.
So now me, I'm one person. Unes tools is spanning some.
Too much,
eh? I don't just work with anyone.
Yeah.
I just look, okay. This, I mean, in everything, in everyone.
Mm.
Yeah. Now you won't just take anyone and...
Exactly.
And, understand?
Yeah, that's what we do.
Yeah, so I felt like my brand... Yes, my brand it's a high-end brand and targeting different people.
Market,
so going back to this thing, Gucci, taking back your stuff,
Ekasi.
Okay. Mm. So I wanted to introduce my work to Soweto.
Yeah.
Okay.
You understand? And the only person that I can do that with was Ulinda.
Mm.
You understand? And Hotmani, it is straightforward.
Mm.
Like, So went to him, was like, yo, let's do this.
Mm.
And then he was like, yo, I've been looking at your work.
Damn.
I have your work, let's do it. We sat and then brainstormed. We did a first two designs.
Yeah.
The designs was to incorporate Ispansa, okay?
Mm.
Ne choose.
Okay.
Or we say, okay, I'm a ninja. It's not a ninja, kasi. I'm a ninja, pume so wait. But the concept didn't work out.
Okay.
I was like, no. This says more of him. It doesn't say more of me.
Okay.
Nah, so started working on something that's going to talk about
what the collaboration. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, bo. So started painting, did portraits, because I do portraits mostly.
Yeah.
I did a portrait that's going to make me feel good. Okay, now I'm satisfied. This is me.
Mm.
Yeah, well, and he's going to be satisfied as well. This is him. Yeah, well, so yeah, that's how it came about. The
collaboration.
The collabo is out there now. People are loving it. The response is good.
Yeah.
Support from the sisters and brothers is there.
Mm.
on social media. So yeah.
So we have like talking about collaboration and everything. Your art, hot man, and now I'm triggered by art. I don't draw, I don't do anything. But when I came across you, hey, I was happy to see you, Eddie Sophie. Like really, I was telling him, I got hot man, and then I'm one person. I don't like to be in people's spaces, But at the same time, the person who brought me there, he told me, "With Mukla Tena." There's potential in you. You need to be around such people, ne?
Sure.
Then when I approached you, I was like, I want to talk about your art, ne? But at the same time, my manager says like, ask him to come and then you'll talk to him, ne? Then thank you for honoring the invite, Hotman.
Yeah, no, thank you. Thank you.
So I've never seen you smile, Hotman, or share ever since.
Now you say, there's a smile.
So would you say that your art, it's somewhat of your reflection that you can portray for yourself, because you are showing to Muntu as tunes and that, because most of your portraits like children smiling. So I wanted to know the art that you do, is it you expressing yourself emotionally or what?
Sure. I like your question. So I grew up as a very, very quiet guy, very shy. The only time I could express how I felt inside was through a paper and a pencil. I was alone most of the time. I had friends, but I preferred peace. I preferred my own space. I'm a dreamer. Like I live in my own world. You understand? I like dreaming out loud. I don't know if you've seen one of the things that I like to post. I like to post astronauts. So the idea behind astronauts is that as a child, they are rebels. They are renegades. Like they stop at nothing. They do whatever that comes in. They're original. They don't fake anything.
Yes.
So
true.
When you see the smile, it's the smile that you get. But it's the same thing as me. When you see my smile, it's the smile that you're gonna get. You see my laughter, it's this laughter that you're gonna get. You understand? So kids are genuine. Like they don't fake anything. So and they always dream out loud. A kid, a 10-year-old is gonna tell you, "Guti, there's a world like a Spider-Man somewhere." Understand? Now, Kuleganjalo as
Dragon Balls.
Dragon Balls exists. You understand? So that's the whole concept of astronauts, because astronauts are people who are always out there, out of the globe. You understand? Out of the club. So as a child, your mind is always out there. You understand? So you're right by saying, "Guti, that's how I express myself. I express myself through paintings and using kids, because kids are original. They don't fake.
They're innocent.
What you get is what you get from them.
So why the fascination of like kids? Because now is it you are bringing out like your inner child in a way, which you didn't have like as we show with both Valera. You don't you seclude yourself from the society. Is it a thing with you when you like it? Sometimes me when I edit, like it's nice seeing people happy and like by smile and enjoying themselves, because I don't get to do that. So by doing that for me, it brings joy to myself. But if people are enjoying and I captured that, that means I was part of this process. So is it the same thing with your with your art? You're expressing it. It's like when you paint, it's like the laughter and seeing that child smile.
So when I say I used to be alone, I'm not saying, you see, I wasn't that child who plays Namanya Bantwana. We used to make amakite. We used to play Ngama 18 as a Zimoto. Understand? We used to play a rope like Mampati. You understand?
You had a child.
Had that. Yeah. You understand? It's just, you see, when it comes to expressing myself, it was for me to be record everything that I've done and express it. You understand? So You know what? As a creative, in fact, I did animation. Yeah. I did 4 years Escala for fine arts, and I did 3 years in animation. Ne? Mm-hmm. And then among Pumescale, I had this thing which I wanna do animation.
Yeah.
He acting I park.
Yeah.
I parked my talent for a very long time. I focused on animation because song fun gens in you woman. But then animation was something I loved, yes, but it didn't bring back that child thing in me.
Mm-hmm.
Up until we had COVID.
Ish.
So being on my board, I too, our car turned, and I was like, let me just paint. We can't go out, COVID time. We can't go out. We can't do anything. Let me just start painting.
Mm.
I painted, and then I posted on social media. Oh, the response was crazy. Everyone was like, you paint.
Mm.
Only like my classmate knew which I was painting.
Yeah.
So everyone was like, you paint? I'm like, yeah. So that's when I started doing more expressing.
You know, looking at artists and people who paint, especially, you know, you look back to Abu Picasso, you know, and like how they are personally, you know, with their personality in terms of around people and society, like they're just different people because for Bona, ideas are always looming out, you know. Yeah. What's my next painting emotionally going to look like? So how do you balance that, man? Like
To be honest, like I look how we live as people.
Yeah.
I get inspired by people. Yeah, but I get inspired by the society on each and every day. It's okay. Today I've experienced this. Because if you look at Leonardo da Vinci, look at Michelangelo, Vincent van Gogh, everything that they created, it was around their society.
Yeah.
Leonardo wasn't just a fine artist, he was also an inventor. So he invented an airplane, I think. So Bonke Labanti, they were inspired by
something,
the society. Yabo, Einstein, inspired by the gravity.
And
I was always fascinated with what makes this thing fall down. It don't try gravity strong. You understand? So abantu around abang inspire kakhulu, and they always keep me pushing, yabo. Because without abantu mfethu ngihlalela endlini nje, I wouldn't have the content or the idea of creating on what's my next a creation, yabo. I wouldn't have that, because another thing is, as artists, you find someone who paints like you. And when you find someone who paints like you, that person might think that you shy spends his skills are
good skills.
That's how you, the only you way you can paint. But then if you see it's okay, now I need to move to this technique. But what's gonna inspire that technique? It's the society.
Yeah.
It's the people around you. So yeah. I got inspired also by Michelangelo. Michelangelo was a sculptors.
Yeah.
He bega shama sculptures, like those big giant sculptures. I'm Zeus. Those Zeus.
Very huge ones.
Greek gods. He used to do those. So lama Greek gods. He wanted to be a different person. But when he was with Leonardo da Vinci, the skill was being accommodated. So, yeah, you get inspired by your society mostly.
Talking about society,
interesting.
We live in a society like Tina. Sometimes it's hard to believe in ourselves, but man, you know. So I wanted to ask a question, Oguti. You ventured in arts at a very young age. We went to school to do animation. How do you keep yourself, like, how do you convince yourself to do that? Because now, people have thoughts of like, am I gonna make money? Because you know, we're made to go to school to believe a certain thing that you're gonna do is gonna bring you money. Mm. And now going to do that and now having a setback, oh, it's okay. I went to school, learned and they didn't matter for no. How do you navigate yourself throughout those thoughts now?
So, okay, so me going to school, Jorang Shilo, I did fine arts.
Yeah.
And I did animation. Reason being, I did fine arts was obviously, fine arts was just a natural talent.
It's an idea, yes, yes.
Understand? Animation, I had to learn computers.
Yeah.
But then, where's the money
yeah.
at that time?
Mm. Yeah.
Remember, it was those times of my social media.
Yeah.
Yeah, bro. But the only thing that sells right now that will make me money animation.
Yeah. yeah.
So I started animation. I did my internships.
Yeah.
I was an intern to this other agency company.
Mm-hmm.
I was a 2D animator.
Yeah.
I was doing yabona lama ama ATMs we bank.
Yeah.
Lezandla lezi zinokubonisa ama instructions.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but ama infographics.
Mm-hmm.
I was doing that.
Mm.
So I was an illustrator and animator.
Abantu nje ukugugula lezi zinto bazifakela phaya.
Ay,
there's people who have seen it and do that.
Create, you create all those things, and then you get someone who's gonna animate it. So I mean, I was an illustrator. I would come up with like character design,
okay.
and background design, and then we have someone who's gonna do like the animation.
Mm.
So that time it was the only way I can make money,
okay.
and I can make a living out of myself and. So that I don't get demotivated.
Mm.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah,
yeah. So, in Intana, as he too, they like fashion.
Mm-hmm.
So, I have a lot of friends about good fashion, big guys
okay.
who are in fashion. So, I always tell them, with your chance, the fashion industry is not easy.
Mm.
Yeah, bro. But then, what you can do, you don't pack it. Try to study something for now
yeah.
that's gonna make you get money.
Mm.
Yeah, well, you can do
it.
Yeah, understand. Yeah. Study something that's gonna it can be anything
yeah.
that you know, Gucci. This thing go market it's very big.
Yeah.
Go industry is very big.
Mm.
Yeah, well, I'm not saying fashion is not. Fashion
it is big.
It is
but
huge,
you must know Gucci fashion here are my trends.
Yeah.
You understand? If your brand is not that established, like me now I have a brand, sorry. Yeah. I have a brand. Right now, but my brand, I put all in my brand,
okay.
but I won't say with you, it's something that's gonna take me out there.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
I need to balance, I need to have my art paintings.
Mm. Yeah.
I need to paint.
Mm.
You understand? I need to look at the business side.
Mm. Yes,
like manji, I've just done I'm a cutlery,
okay.
doing cutleries, putting my art there. Mm. I'm doing I'm a carpets, I'm a rugs. Putting my art there.
Oh, nice.
You find a lot of ways
to gravitate to art.
Make
yeah.
to make money. Yeah, why not? So don't stick to one thing because you think okay, this is what's gonna
I'm
get
perfect. For you.
Yeah. yeah.
Damn.
You need to break it down and say it's okay. I'm a podcaster.
Yeah.
Good podcasting. Good nana many elements that
yeah.
make money.
Yeah. True.
Yeah, understand.
True.
I'm graphic design, go graphic design. I'm a permanent element. You understand? So those things, you break them down.
Yeah.
Put you on a sticky to one thing,
okay.
and then you are kawatee.
Mm.
Yeah, and then you are demotivated. Like no.
Always have a plan that you're going to fall into.
Always have a plan.
Yeah.
But your plan needs to be closer to your talent.
Mm. They need to complement each other with like seven
designs.
I think, you know, we spoke too much, but now, like, I just want to ask for someone who's watching, ne, Uguzi, when they see your work, ne, I think it is very important for them to know, especially from you, Uguzi, in your paintings, because you spoke about, you know, children having wild dreams and being innocent and original. So, Mina, I want to know, Guti, what message are you trying to convey, you know, with your art?
The whole idea in my art is happiness.
Mm.
Yeah, it's happiness. And the sky is not the limit.
Mm.
Yeah.
Your dreams are beyond that. You understand? Whatever you dream of, you can achieve
I'm
it.
I'm a gatekeeper.
So many times. No, forget about I'm a gatekeeper. Yeah. Like, yeah, when I learned as a gatekeeper, guys, it's been there. But people have achieved still when I'm a gatekeeper.
Gone,
I'm a gatekeeper can be anyone, not like us. Okay. You understand? So do not have that mentality. Because if you're going to have that mentality, when I'm a gatekeeper, you're not going to go anywhere. You're not. You need to find a way of making it. There's always a way, boy. Like, if you change, by when I learned to lay maze, by being on the maze runner.
Maze runner.
There's always a way to come out from that.
Mm. Okay. You're gonna get stuck. Find a way. Yes. Come back.
And it's, that's how life is.
Man, I find it difficult when you give these motivations. I'm looking at the people who are surrounded, like, what DJs, who they came, bought your art, your one.
Yeah.
So I feel like when you give us motivation, when you talk about that, I want to be like you, you know, because now, okay, you can give me motivation. Now, better motivation, I believe it's something for a smaller time, because now I can be motivated. Then when I step out of the room, I face reality. So
there's this one thing, it made people talk. Yeshua, Jay-Z, ati life starts after church. So that depends on how you see it, how you take it.
Okay,
do you take it Guti was against Christianity, or you're gonna take it as in he was saying, Guti, whatever the pastor has said to you there, are you gonna take it or not?
Okay,
we understand. So maupuma, you make a decision, it's okay. It's okay. The pastor said, I must sin still. The pastor said, I must sin still. I must go and find the job.
Yeah.
I understand. What's the decision I'm making? You understand? I can tell you and motivate you and get inspired. But at the end of the day, you need to act on it. Because they always get motivated. And sometimes we're going to come to a point where we don't want to be motivated because we see it's pointless. And it helps being motivated so that you can understand, no, man, there's no such thing as gatekeepers. There's no such thing, you can rely on one career path. You understand? When God made man, he said, these things here, they are all yours. You understand? So you are capable of anything. You understand, dog? So there's nothing that's going to limit you. Yeah, bro. If someone can able to fly, so what's going to help you to create something that's going to fly? Understand? So there's nothing that's stopping you to create.
I know, Hotman, you actually call me about dreams because when you call me fly, you talked about someone building a plane and no fly loco like us, it's mental things, you know.
Understand.
So, I know why you shared a lot, Hotman, and you shared a lot. So, can you share a little bit about like branding ourselves to become like an Elliot Sitor? Like, how do can we create our brand, the ASM Chronicles, to look appealing?
So as Nishilo before, which you know, he target, you know your people, you know who you're talking to.
Yeah,
you understand. You know who you're selling your product to. You understand, and you know where you want to take your product. You understand. I get asked a lot. Sometimes people would say, "I guy, it's not good to see like." Anything. People will ask me, we're doing a market, a car, see, a strategy. Don't you want to come and put your t-shirts there?
Yeah.
Understand?
Yeah.
I I won't say no.
Yeah.
I'll just say I'll see.
Okay.
You understand? Why I'm saying that, I know back of my mind, I won't go there.
Yeah. Okay.
Because already my t-shirt or my brand is not positioned to be there.
Yeah. Brand positioning.
Damn. Brand positioning.
Yeah.
So we don't need to settle for less because someone.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. You won't find about this easy. Uma street market.
Yeah. 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 Facts, yeah.
It depends who's there and who's gonna be buying
there.
Okay.
You understand? So, brand positioning is very important, and brand identity also is very important.
Okay.
How you identify your brand, Mongeko, you understand? Mm. Like, I come across, like, a lot of people, they don't know me, but they know the brand.
Yeah.
You understand? So I'll come to a place, go a t-shirt, and then a guy will say, yo, So only later Mchita will come and say, flip,
and then he went to check then.
Yeah.
So in such moment, why don't you embrace yourself? That's me. It's my friend.
Ivana, I don't know. I think I'm built different. I'm a very, I'll say, I don't know, I'm a very humble person.
Yeah.
I don't like to be in people's faces.
Yeah.
Rather let my brand be there.
Be there.
Me now.
Ikhulumele
yourself. Yeah, because I don't want this thing singing in Daweni.
It's on my bus.
Yeah, so rather let it be, let it. Because I enjoy people talking.
Yeah.
Near brand, Mauda. They can say bad things. Those bad things, you take them. It's like, okay, we should say, let print yasura. Let me go and fix it. You understand? Oh, let t-shirt, let me say, quality. They saw all those things next to me. So I'm going to see Nami.
Yeah.
So imagine if they knew me. Yimi da nyazaz. They will never say such things. But then, Ogutu, now when you use Toby, one twin engine, just be yourself. Let your work speak.
Speak for you.
For, yeah.
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 Oh, that's good. So, who is really your target market?
Yeah.
I'm fine. I mean,
I
want to have a spanner.
That is your span.
I want to have a spanner. Yeah, now my students, lo maliom kero, they say about
because lento lengi buziswa. I've realized ukuthi most of the people like who have brands and who are in fashion most of the time, like, it is rare to get your peers like becoming your target market.
Yes, that's true.
Like it's rare, man. So I want to understand that thing, Yoguti. Like when do you know how to, you know, get your peers, you know, to like the brand and, you know, and associate yourself with them? Or is that thing, Yoguti? Because of Elliot, you know, I can't imagine looking at him, guy spotlight while I also want the spotlight. So, like, what's happening there?
Okay, so something I didn't say before. So, when I was starting my agency, I had an agency called Creative Mindspace. So, Creative Mindspace was an agency that creates brands. So I was a brand architect. So I've created a lot of brands. Brands like Abu Skinny Spoo Socks. I've worked Amachance Wami. I've worked Abu Tepo Jeans. Tepo Jeans is one of my best friends. And I've worked my brands called Kicks. I've once did something Nyana Nepa too that time. So there's my circle. My circle is very motivational. Like I'm motivated and know what, okay, who are my peers and who are my target.
Yes,
understand. So if you ploma, which miles of ploma no Bill Gates. Bitcoin to enter a billion in a week. Ploma na Do you think when you're offering 100 rand a week?
No, I wouldn't. I want to make more than that.
You're going to want to make more than that. Yeah. So those people, is very important. So those people, they motivate you to know your peers and say, okay, for now, when we target them, who's up by skipper Sam? You understand?
Yeah.
You need to be honest to yourself. Business has this, it doesn't have this thing good to you. Who's begging your pants?
Yeah.
You need to be honest and straightforward. It's okay. If it's t-shirt time, it's 700.
Yeah.
You understand? If I'm going to say, tight market time, or drive a Porsche, then I'm not going to compromise.
Yeah.
Yeah, bro. Hey. So you find yourself and you find the business where you want to take it.
Okay.
Yeah, and stick to that.
Yeah.
Don't change anything and try to accommodate.
Because
you're so
yo, that's that's rich.
There's more
man.
Questions.
Yeah. That's rich. Yeah.
Do you have any questions?
Yeah, man. I want to know Gutwe, now how do you balance like creativity with business? Yeah. Because we have seen, you know, when it comes to let me say filming. For example, you know, you would see umuntu, you know, who wants to direct, you know, funo gena acte futhi, you know, and do all of those things, and then hlangahlanganikhanda. So wena, how do you balance the two?
Vana, find your strength.
Yeah.
And stick to one thing. Because if you're gonna try to do a lot of things, remember I said you see a business and a creativity. Yeah. On a talent, it's different things.
Yeah.
So if those things they don't balance, then it's pointless to try to grow the other thing.
Yes.
So find your niche into your creativity and the business, and focus into it. And then know about a strategy. It's a business.
Yeah.
It's okay. Where do you wanna take your business in after a year? When I started. I started at Edgar's.
Yeah.
My plan was to have like a retail shop.
Okay.
But the retail shop came in a different way.
Yeah.
Edgar's approached me and said, "Yo, dog, what's the fuck isn't that? I want to partner with you."
Mm.
You understand?
Yeah.
So when you set up your mind into it as a creative, it's okay in the business, this is my title, I want to achieve this.
Yes. Yes.
Then you go for that.
Okay.
You attract that.
Oh.
Yeah, well, so that's the difference between the creative side and the business side.
Yeah.
You find your niche and then you grow the business and let the business grow the talent.
The
as
talent.
Well. Yeah.
Very nice, man. Very wise words, man, you know, from the one and only Elliot. So as Sizwe Vala right now, one thing I want to know from you is that do you have any, you know, brand that you wish to collaborate with?
Yeah.
Oh, well, I don't have a specific brand that I wish to collaborate with. I love ideas. I'm always open to ideas. I can even collaborate with you guys.
Yeah. It would be nice.
Yeah. I love ideas. I'm open to anything with anyone.
Oh.
Yeah, well, but as I said as well, it needs to make sense into my brand.
Yeah.
It needs to position my brand very well.
Mm.
Yeah, well, it needs to position your brand very well.
Very well too.
Yeah, well, so I'm not stuck into who I want to collaborate with.
Yes, yes.
I've learned a lot in this collaboration. I'm Nolinda, and I've understood as in Yizinto in between. He taught me a lot of things as a business person. That guy works. That guy, he lives his brand. So, I'm always open to any idea or any idea of collaborating. But I'll tell you if you bring your mind doesn't suit, I'll say
next time
that will build our brand to collaborate with you, Hotman, because you want to be in the spaces of like inspiring the upcoming generation. That's why we started KTS Conversation, to have guests to share such stories as yours, because your story is unique. Because now from seeing someone for hot man, because it's very important. Me, my surrounding from a custom, there's no, there are people who came from my hood, but they didn't come back. You know, I can mention actors from Generation back in the day, but having moments like this for me, it means a lot, hot man, for coming, for honoring, because it's like, at least not tomorrow when someone's gonna watch this, they're gonna believe it's possible, because we've never met. I'm not your friend, I've seen hot man now, but for taking this time and coming to sit here, yo, it's gonna build.
So for anyone, you know, who wants to become an entrepreneur, an artist, a painter, you know, what do you have for them?
I'll say, first of all, believe in yourself. That's the most, I think, general thing. Believe in yourself.
Be yourself.
Be yourself. I never said.
You understand?
Yeah.
Don't take any negative things from people. Listen and decide.
Yeah.
But do not take negative ideas from people. Don't listen to people gonna tell you, Gucci, it's not possible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
You are greater than you think.
Yeah.
And always be I always tell you know what, a life in is you are given a chance. Right? And when you are given a chance, the chance comes once.
Yeah.
And the andlula, you understand?
Yeah.
If you look at other brands that I won't mention names that were big, they've passed.
Yes.
And for them to come back, they'll never come back.
When given an opportunity in the future.
So when you're given an opportunity and time, use it wisely. Yeah, bro. Use it wisely. Don't be scared on asking questions. Don't be scared on having mentors. Most the another most important thing, have a mentor. A mentor, a person who's aligned to what you wanna do.
Yeah.
Or what your future relies on. You understand? So yeah, believe in yourself, and the sky is not a limit.
Yeah.
Your dreams are beyond that.
The rest will fall.
As brother Edward said, first and
do it, man. Do it. But other than that, thank you so much, man, for making time to sit down with us. And I have learned a lot. And of course, they are learning a lot, of course, and they will take that. Yeah. So yeah, man. Any last words?
ASM Chronicles.
Please subscribe ASM Chronicles. Yeah, I'm a chance. Shai Spanish into him.
Thank you, Hotman. Raikwala.
Raikwala, Bafit. As Brother Elliot says, you are greater than you think and brighter than you feel.
Yo.
My name is Muketi, my man, and this was Ata, and this was the KTS Conversation. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, press the notification button. We'll see you next time. Shout out and peace out.
Yo, yo, yo. Don't forget, kids, a little postang, right? It's the like of things as the SAM Chronicles family will be bringing you content from Ekas. Bona vibes, real G-shit, not the scripted content, and very like things, and so why not? It actually all started when we would post random videos of us chilling or either going out and stuff. Until little did we know that.